Hey guys, it's Scott here and welcome to today's early morning content video. This is the Premier League Player of the Month for October and it is about to be revealed in just a few seconds. We are going to take a look at the SBC, we're going to show you how much it costs, what the requirements are, whether I think it's worth it, and any other information that you may require. So if you do enjoy this video, please do make sure you hit the thumbs up. Subscribe if you're new. On our road to 90k subs by the end of the year is our target. We need every single one of you new people to join us if we are to hit it. You can see daily streams and videos. We will be streaming Foot Champs later today. Who knows? Maybe on the PS4 account we will be using this card. I'm not too sure. But without further ado, we're going to get into this thing in about 30 seconds, so let's see what EA have got for us today. If you're looking to pick yourself up some coins for Foot 21, then make sure to click my link in the description, go to U7Buy, and make sure you use my code Birdie at checkout to get 5% off of your order. So the nominees, obviously we've got some big players that are available. Heung Min Son would be by far the most meta player that could win this award. I personally think Harry Kane is about to win in 3, 2, 1, let's have a look. Are they going to release it bang on time? That is the question. SBCs, no, they're not. Is there a tweet out? No, there isn't. Come on, EA. Oh my god, it is Son. Oh, it's going to be so expensive. So damn expensive. Right, let's get into this then. 89 rated Heung Min Son. Let's compare his base card to his new player of the month. Where is it? Heung Min Son. So, he has gone from obviously 87 to 89. Player of the month always go up by two, as if it was two upgrades. He's got two more pace, two more shooting, four more passing, two more dribbling, two defending, and three physical. It's really not that big an upgrade. If we're being perfectly honest, it's not a huge upgrade. Passing is the biggest one, obviously going up by four, but the other ones going up by two, and it's okay, but it's not outrageous, okay? It's not as if he's going up by five in every stat. Now, his base card is costing about 150k on PlayStation and 120k on Xbox. Now, obviously, he hasn't changed skills or weak foot or anything like that. 5-star weak foot, 4-star skills, high work rates. Pace is obviously great. Shooting stats are fantastic. You're most likely going to end up whacking this guy up front or at cam. Passing stats are okay. How much did they change? So, short passing and long passing and vision just all went up by 4, a blanket upgrade. Dribbling stats, obviously very good. Stamina 91. He has finesse shot trait. So, his base card, very good this year. Very good. If you haven't used it, I would recommend trying him out. The only problem with Heung Min Son is his links. But my prediction for this SBC, if his base card is, let's say, 150k, maybe a little bit less than that, an inform in that same position should cost about 300. Second inform would normally cost probably about 500, 600k. That's my prediction here. Oh my. So, we start things off with an 85 rated squad. Now, I don't know if there are any other SBCs in the game that we can even judge the price of this off of. So we need an 85, an 86, an 87, and an 88 where you get an untradeable pack. So, if you invested in fodder, well done, because it is going to have gone up in price. I don't know what the most expensive SBC that's out is to compare it to be honest with you. Let me quickly have a little look through Footbin. I don't think there's anyone that comes even close to close. Is it possible to see expired SBCs on Footbin? Expired. It is. Did we have anyone that was outrageously... Fatty is probably the closest that we've had. Fatty was coming in at 200,000 coins. He needed an 86, which is this part. This was costing about 100k. His 85 cost about 65. So you're already looking at, and that's without an inform. So you're looking at about 175k for this part. If that's 100k, I say 100 175k. This is going to be a minimum of 125k. Maybe, like, 140. So, if that takes us to roughly 200, that's going to take us to about 325k. And then 88, maybe, like, 175k. It probably is going to come in at an estimate of about 500,000 coins. I might be low in my estimate, to be honest with you. I might be low. And that would be a little bit worrying for people if I was. But, oh, you need an inform in the 87 as well. Maybe more like 550k, something like that for Heung Min Son. I may do it on my content account. Will I do it on the Road to Glory? Absolutely not. I don't think there's any reason that I would do this. The thing is with Son's stats, they're already good on his base card. They're really, really good. Especially if you play him at cam like I did. Then you can basically... The passing is the big one. The passing is the big upgrade here. And by big, I mean 4. I normally class big upgrades on FIFA as 5+. But still, it's okay. The other stats just haven't gone up that much. So I don't know how many people are going to do this, to be honest with you. I'd like to know your thoughts in the comments section, whether you think this is good value, whether you will be doing this. Obviously, you've got a month to do it, so there's a chance that over the next month, when does this expire then? 29 days is, what, like the 11th or 12th of December, something like that. So you've got a long time. And Footmas may even be underway by the time that this comes out. Son may have already got one, maybe even two more informs by the time this expires. And if he does get an inform, then there's even a chance that that inform may be a central card as well. So I would definitely advise, unless you've specifically got the stuff in your club, thinking that this was going to come out for the exact price of the stuff that you wanted it to be, I'd probably say hold off. If you like Son, use his normal card. Wait to see what the price of this thing comes in at and whether you think that it is actually going to be worth it. Because it's a lot. It is a lot. The question is whether the high-rated fodder is finally going to actually go up in price. Because some people have been holding on. Even like 83s and 84s may go up. But someone like a Testegen, for example, may massively shoot up in price now. So if I quickly check his price, 50 minutes ago, Testegen cost 37,000 coins on Xbox. So let's have a very quick check as part of this video so that I can give you a little bit of info as to whether the fodder prices are going to go up to make this even more expensive than the predictions are. And if it does, then he'll go to 600k plus. So if this Testegen is 40k or above right now, this SBC is going to be outrageously expensive. Okay, so it does not look like, as it stands, instantaneously, these cards have gone up by much. Although it's only been out for 7 minutes, and he has gone up by, well actually no, he's gone up by about 500 coins as it stands. So, okay, let's check another one. I just want to check a few so that you guys will be able to have this information ready to go. Who is a prime fodder player? Again, another keeper. Let's go with Courtois. So half an hour ago, Courtois was pretty much 30,000 coins. 30,000 coins for Courtois. You can still get him for that. So the one thing is that because so many people may have invested in high-rated cards, and because this SBC is going to be so expensive, you may see the market actually get flooded with these fodder players that people have invested in for the last few weeks. And there is a tiny chance that they actually come down because of how expensive the SBC is. These cards could come down if people think that the SBC, if the general consensus is that the SBC is too expensive, a bit like Player of the Month Messi last year. The first player of the month, Messi, that we got was outrageously overpriced, and so fodder price actually came down rather than going up. And so a lot of people lost a lot of money. Now, this isn't anywhere near as expensive as that was last year. So I don't know what people are going to do with this one. I think it's hard to call. My personal opinion, the stats upgrade doesn't really warrant him costing over four times as much. Maybe even up to as high as five times as much as his base card. I would hold off, and if you're tempted to do it, maybe wait a week or two to see if he potentially has a chance of getting another inform, see what happens with the prices on the market, and then make your decision. But those are my thoughts. Let me know yours in the comment section down below. Are you going to do this SBC? What do you think of the value? And yeah, we're going to be live later today so we can discuss it more. Make sure your sub with notifications turned on so you don't miss us when we start that foot champ stream. I'll see you guys then. Thank you very much for watching. Goodbye.